On this episode of City View, 100 Homes Campaign, what Austin is doing to fight homelessness. Operation Outreach, the city promotes volunteerism while helping female veterans. An animal shelter will take you inside the city's brand new pet adoption facility. Thanks for joining us. I'm your host, Leslie Sopko. Those stories and more. But first, our top story. It's affordable, it's green, and it's a hop, skip, and a jump from the train. M Station, located near the Metro Rail Red Line, is Austin's first affordable complex in a transit-oriented district. Congressman Lloyd Doggett, Mayor Lee Leffingwell, and community officials joined together to dedicate this affordable community in East Austin.
What we've tried to do at M Station is really think about the whole family budget. So the biggest thing in your budget is usually your housing costs. So affordable rent was at the top of our list.
As part of its Roof Over Austin initiative to end homelessness, the city of Austin contributed $2 million in bonds toward the project's affordable housing units. M Station connects Austin residents to transportation and other opportunities to become self-sufficient. Learn more at foundcom.org. Austin City Council members have joined forces with the Ending Community Homelessness Coalition. They're working together on the 100 Homes campaign, which is dedicated to ending homelessness in the Austin region.
We can do a better job as a society of addressing those very human needs, and this registry is a first step in that effort.
The problem is that we've been planning to end homelessness for a long, long time, and it's an exciting time in the city of Austin because I believe that we really are putting all the pieces together to make that happen and to really make a dent.
The effort is straightforward. Find 100 of Austin's most vulnerable folks experiencing homelessness. Then work collaboratively to get a roof over their head. 100 Homes is part of the national 100,000 Homes campaign. The initiative takes a housing first approach, which means housing people first, and then using that stable base to begin tackling other challenges like substance abuse and mental health. More than 80 volunteers have begun to reach out to homeless individuals to gather information. Find out how you can join the effort at 100homesaustin.org. Mayor Lee Leffingwell, Councilmember Kathy Tovo, and Central Texas Red Cross CEO Marty McKellips announced a new initiative to provide support and services to female military veterans. Operation Outreach connects female veterans with confidential support from volunteers and veterans in the Austin area, who can mentor them as they reintegrate into civilian life.
For Operation Outreach, for me, coming just back and being just retired, it benefits me knowing that I've got something in the local area, and I can't wait to see what kind of services and stuff that they're going to be able to offer in that program, so we can get the word out to more veterans. I know me personally, I'm very excited about reaching out to them and seeing what they have, and hopefully me and my family can benefit from it.
Operation Outreach is part of the Cities of Service initiative led by the mayor's office to help address problems facing our community with volunteerism. To volunteer or to get help, call 512-929-1277 or visit centex.redcross.org. The Waller Creek Conservancy is hosting an international design competition to find the most innovative and qualified architects and artists to design and transform the Waller Creek District into a workable and livable area. A competition jury has been established to select a winner, and the finalists will compete in a design competition. For more information on the three stages of the competition and to register, visit wallercreek.org/competition. After 60 years of operation, the Town Lake Animal Center closed its doors on November 9th and reopened as the Austin Animal Center in a new state-of-the-art facility on Lavander Loop.
Let's open the Animal Center.
The 41,000 square foot facility not only includes comfortable hygienic housing for animals and greatly improved medical facilities, but also includes spaces for educational and prevention activities and a pleasant park-like setting for visitors. The Animal Center is an open intake facility where animals in need of shelter are accepted regardless of age, health, species, or breed. It is the goal of the Austin Animal Center to place all adoptable animals in a permanent home. With the turning of a purple water valve, the Austin Water Utility celebrated its new reclaimed water system at Austin-Bergstrom International Airport, marking another milestone for the utility's reclaimed water program. The new system will begin supplying reclaimed water for the airport's irrigation system, saving the airport 25 million gallons of drinking water annually. Reclaimed water is created by using highly treated wastewater for non-drinking purposes.
Reclaimed water is highly treated wastewater effluent. It's an important part of our conservation programs and our drought response to convert larger customers to reclaimed water. We're very pleased with the success of this project. The partnership with the airport, our reclaimed system water is growing. Over 1 billion gallons a year now of reclaimed water is distributed to customers of the Austin Water Utility, and that's a big part of a successful, sustainable future.
And finally, City of Austin Channel 6 has received over 25 awards this year for programming. This includes the Overall Excellence in Programming Award from the National Association of Telecommunications Officers and Advisors, and is the highest honor given to government television stations. Channel 6 followed that big win with two Lone Star Emmy nominations, with Jonathan Yule and James Williams winning a joint entry for Outstanding Achievement in Television Photography. The Lone Star Emmy is a regional competition between all video production professionals in Texas. Congratulations to the entire Channel 6 team. And that's all for this edition of City View. I'm your host, Leslie Sopko. Our next episode premieres Friday, December 9th. Thanks for watching.